subtraction is everywhere, all around us. You can see it when you buy 5 more lives on Candy Crush for a buck. It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes. You take the blue gift card. The story ends. You're back in elementary school, subtracting lines on a chalkboard. You take the red gift card. And we see how deep this hole can go.
Whoa.
Up until this moment, you probably believed subtraction was a fact of life.
You'd believe that if you spent a buck on a book on jiu-jitsu and then paid the clerk $10, you'd get $9 back.
Nope. Subtraction isn't real.
10 minus 1 is the same thing as 10 plus negative 1.
Subtracting a signed number is the same thing as adding its opposite, or additive inverse.
Subtraction doesn't exist.
Subtraction doesn't exist.
The matrix has been revealed.
Heads up! For your entire math career, it has been hands off the operation. Well, guess what? Now you can change the operation from subtraction to addition just by changing the sign after the operation. Crazy, right? This is an example of A minus B equals A plus negative B. This is one of the big moments I remember in math.
Addition and subtraction exist as two sides of the same coin. They're anywhere positive and negative forces collide. Good and bad feelings, national politics, and even right here in Gotham. Gotham was once a good city. There were positive people, like Alfred. Add a positive number, move in the positive direction. But over time, Gotham was corrupted by criminals. Add a negative number, move in a negative direction. But then, Batman came.
Hey, Math Club.
And he started cleaning up all the criminals. Notice that subtracting the negatives and adding a positive did the same thing. They both moved it in the positive direction, making Gotham safer. But then the Joker came and kidnapped Rachel Dawes and Harvey Dent and turned Harvey Dent into Two-Face. Adding a negative and subtracting a positive both moved Gotham in the negative direction towards chaos. But at the last minute, Batman captured the Joker, saved the hostages, and rounded up the thugs. In case you're wondering, I'm not gonna do the plot for Dark Knight Rises because that movie was too crazy.
The great Mr. Math Club, we meet at last.
Wait. I'm negative. Subtracting a negative should make things more negative. I bet that you can't think of one example that two negatives make a positive.
Really?
Okay. Well, I don't not like him.
Don't not. Chica, that means you like him.
Holy double negatives, Batman. Two negatives makes a positive.
Busted. Our work is done here. Quick, to the Nebuchadnezzar.
Sometimes the matrix forces you to add or subtract long strings of numbers for homework. Even if you understand this concept, it can be really hard to see through the matrix. See if this helps. Draw circles around all of the operations and the numbers that come after it. See any circles with two negative signs? Make it a positive. This is one case where two wrongs do make a right. Next, put plus signs in between all of the circles if they aren't there already. Lastly, add them all up. Remember, positive numbers move you in the positive direction and negative numbers move you in the negative direction. This tip is a beta, so let us know if it's helpful or not.
Think you can handle the matrix? Head on over to the quiz to see what you've learned. Or unlearned.
Have a story where positive and negative forces collide? Make one up and put it in the comments section. We'd love to read it.
And remember what you learned. Subtraction is a lie. Subtraction is a lie. The lie!
1/3 minus negative 16/23. That is the sound of inevitability.
71/69. Negative 6 minus negative 7.
Negative 13.
27 minus negative 64.
91. 42 minus 39.
It's so hard. I can't explain how hard it is.
Do not try and subtract numbers. That's impossible. Instead, change the sign, add a line.
Change the sign, add a line. I thought there was something more to it than that.
Nah, it's pretty easy.